You're watching What's Hot on CNBC TV 18. Some sectors of Indian exports are showing signs of revival, so says the Commerce Secretary G.K. Pillai. Shireen Bhan caught up with him and began by asking him which sectors were showing some signs of recovery.
Well, I'm seeing in leather, we've got the figures now over the last 3 months, and we are seeing that for the year, last year, we have grown at 3% in dollar terms and 19% in rupee terms for the leather sector, which is a labor-intensive sector. We are seeing most of our textile mills are now running at full capacity, though only for the next 60 days because orders are in short supply. Engineering, pharmaceuticals, agricultural exports, these are doing well.
You said the next 6 months will continue to be challenging or painful. That $175 billion mark, sir, do you actually expect us to go anywhere close to that?
Well, this year we will touch $170 billion, and with world trade expected to contract by 9%, we are still keeping a target of $170 to $175 billion for next year, which means an 8 to 9% growth. And I think that we will be able to achieve it with the fine-tuning in our policy.
What's the sense that you're getting in terms of job losses? Because there have been alarming figures put out by various industry bodies. The government has also alluded to some of them. But what's the sense that you're now getting on the ground in terms of job losses?
I think we have seen that the job losses which have taken place are now almost, we've reached the bottom. We're bottoming out there. It's about 10 to 15 lakh jobs which we have lost. And I expect that in the next 3 months, post-April, I think very small, we will start getting new jobs being created.
So the global commodity cycle has changed. We've seen global commodity prices crashing significantly. What about futures trade and the ban on the 8 commodities in India? Is there the possibility of a review as far as that ban is concerned or suspension is concerned?
At the moment, I don't think these are likely to be reviewed. I think the commodity prices are going to be tight, and we don't really expect much growth, at least for the next 6 months.
So what about wheat exports? Because the EGOM has actually given an in-principle nod to wheat exports, but a notification hasn't come out. Is there any thought on pushing that forward? Because the Election Commission gave you the go-ahead to remove the duties on sugar. So what about wheat? Could we actually see some forward movement there?
Well, we are basically watching the situation to see finally what the wheat procurement for this year, which seems to be good. And therefore, as soon as the elections are over, I think wheat exports will come.
In terms of clarification on the norms for the toy manufacturers now, will these apply to domestic toy manufacturers as well? Of course, 90% is imports in India, but will they apply to the domestic toy manufacturers as well? Because this is a nascent business in India.
Well, I think the safety of Indian children is uppermost in everybody's mind. We can't have unsafe toys for our children also. So the BIS have already laid down the standards for toys. In India. I expect that we are in consultation with the other ministries, Department of Industries, Department of Small and Medium Industries, and I'm hopeful that we would be able to come to a compromise solution, and these standards would get notified possibly within the next 60 days.
Balance of payment situation now. Most analysts believe that we should turn positive in FY10. What's the sense that you're getting?
So still too early to say, because I've still not seen really the movement of FIIs back into the Indian market. I think most of them would be analyzing the situation the post-April. And then I expect that there would be a certain element of FII inflow into India, and that could be in the order of $10 to $20 billion.
We will have a new government in place, whether it will be the UP or the BJP or a third front government, hopefully by the first week of June. There has been the call for another big stimulus package, especially from the exporter point of view. Do we have room to be able to push anything big bang, sir?
I really think in one sense, insofar as the exports are concerned, we may not really need a big bang stimulus package. I think what we really need is what I would really call as trust the exporter attitude towards the trade. And if that can be brought in as part of the new 2009-14 foreign trade policy, I think that would be of great help to the exporters.